Hi, I'm Dave Cosmo with Comcast Public Access TV, and we're here at the Rockland County Community College. I'm here with Mark, and Mark's going to tell us a little bit about himself and a little bit about boating safety. How you doing, Mark?
Thank you very much. I'm Captain Mark Bologna from Landfall Navigation in Stamford, Connecticut. We're off exit 6 off the Turnpike in Stamford. Our website is www.landfallnavigation.com. We specialize in marine safety equipment, marine outfitting, life rafts, EPIRBs, PLBs, things of that nature. Dave asked me to talk about PLBs in particular. PLB is a personal locator beacon. These are an example of, this is a ACR, personal locator beacon. These will bring help to you when you need it if you are in distress. They work almost on the same par with an EPIRB, which is a emergency indicating radio beacon, with a few exceptions. A PLB is registered to the person, not to the vessel as an EPIRB is. These little gadgets here can be invaluable to you if you are hiking on a boat, up in the woods, ATV, skiing, snowmobiling. If you get into trouble and for some reason you cannot reach help, you activate a PLB and it will summon help through a GPS signal, is how they locate you in this little unit. It uses a Copris SARSAT satellite system to locate you on the face of the globe. And emergency people, whether it's Forestry Service or if you're on the water, it'd be Coast Guard. Inland waters would be DEP or local Marine Police will come to help you out.
So these are pretty interesting. I always advocate, as you know, I'm a American Heart Association CPR instructor, first aid instructor, and I know this is one of the most important things that anybody should take with them. Do you have any stories you can tell where these things could have actually saved someone's life and be very useful?
Yes, I had a customer in that was out west. I believe it was Montana. That would their form of recreation was to go on ATVing. And this gentleman, his wife got thrown off of her ATV, and he had to ride out because she wasn't able to get herself out. He had to ride out a couple of hours to get help and then return a couple hours later with somebody to help them out. And he purchased a PLB for just that reason, that if that happened again, he wouldn't have had to have left her by herself to go summon help. He could have used the PLB to get somebody in there to help them.
So now, exactly how do these operate?
What they'll do is when you press the button, there's a button on here, it will send a signal to a series of satellites. Satellites detect your location on the globe through the GPS unit that's contained inside the unit. Once they detect where you're located, there's a central center that will in turn summon the proper help or the proper authorities to your location. In other words, if you're up in the mountains, obviously the Coast Guard isn't going to come looking for you. But if you're, again, if you're up in the mountains, it's going to be the forestry people or state police or whoever the Copper SARSAT satellite system determines your location on the globe. That's who they're going to summon the help from. And these work not only in the U.S., but anywhere on the globe.
Now, how do these differ from some of the other devices that are out there? I think there's another device called Spot. Is there a difference between this particular one and that one?
Yeah, the Spot uses Global Star satellites, which are private telecommunication satellites. And they are a little bit less reliable than this system. This system uses NOAA and Copper SARSAT satellites, which are government satellites, versus private telecommunication satellites. Now, the Spot has its own unique function where you can be tracked with it, which most of these units don't do. It's not a tracking device like a Spot or a text messaging device like a Spot. These are strictly life-threatening situations. And I actually had a great story from an older gentleman who was out west. He was in his 80s. And he said, you know, in what kind of situation do I use this? And I said, life-threatening situations only. And he says, I'm 83. That could be every morning when I get up is a life-threatening situation. So, yeah, and he was a pretty nice fellow. And what his thing was he lived in Washington State, and he would drive in the springtime down to Texas, which is a pretty good drive for a fellow that age, good drive for anybody. And he brought one of these with him for exactly the same reason, that if something happened to him, he would be able to switch it on, and hopefully the authorities would be able to find him.
Now, what's the longevity or the life expectancy of a device like this?
They're all going to be, they all have five-year batteries. So at the end of the five-year battery, that is their date stamped on here. At the end of the 5 years, depending on the manufacturer, you either send it back to a authorized battery replacement center. Some of them will have user replaceable batteries, so you simply purchase the battery and install it yourself. But again, they're all going to be, it's mandated that they have a five-year battery. That's if the unit is not used. If it's used, obviously if you have to switch it on, then that time decreases and you should replace the battery.
Okay, now is there any type of seals? And that's, I assume you send it back to the manufacturer because those seals need to be replaced, is that correct?
Correct. PLBs are going to be, they come in a variety of different configuration sizes. Some of them are buoyant, some of them are not. But they're sealed units, they're waterproof, they're all waterproof. So that's the purpose of, there's going to be a seal or a gasket in there that has to go back into place properly. Some of the manufacturers don't want the user to do that themselves. They'd rather have a certified facility do that to make sure that it's properly reassembled and that it's going to work. The other thing with the PLB is that the broadcast duration of the actual distress signal on most PLBs is 24 hours. There is one PLB by a manufacturer, McMurdo. It's the only one that I know of that it's called the Max G that will actually broadcast a signal for 48 hours. And if that's a concern of yours, if you're really in the wilderness where it may be a long time before help is arriving, you would want to consider getting one that has the 48-hour broadcast duration of that signal.
Now, you mentioned that these can be tracked anywhere in the world, is that correct?
Yeah, anywhere global.
But now, if you are lost or you need help in the United States, help will come. But if you're outside of the United States, then what happens then?
It's going to be depending on where you are in the world, it would be their emergency response people. In other words, it would be in the Bahamas, it would be the Bahamian authorities. Again, we register in the United States, we register our PLBs with NOAA. I've had people in various countries. They can be reprogrammed for another country for people who live or reside outside of the U.S. But if you're in another country's waters or another country, period, it's going to be up to their emergency response people to respond to this. So you'd want to make sure that their emergency response people are part of this system and that they're going to come respond to a PLB or an EPIRB type signal.
Now let me ask you one more question. If I were to deploy this unit and I was in another country, would they also alert immediate family members? So if they could not come and get me, other family members would be aware that a loved one would be lost, or it'd be a crucial emergency if I was skiing or something of that nature?
Yes, and actually I had a fellow a couple weeks ago call, and his issue was he was going to a foreign country, I'd rather not name it, that his concern was getting kidnapped. And what you do when you register a PLB is you're going to have a list of folks that are going to be notified if the PLB is activated. So what happened in his case is he left word with obviously some of his loved ones and said, if you get a signal or a call and this thing goes off, it's the real deal. And that these folks that he listed on the registration were who will be contacted in that list or in that order.
Well, I certainly don't think there's any questions about it. I mean, this is just absolutely a phenomenal item, a device, and I'm not sure, how long has this been around?
PLBs have been on the market now probably about 7 years. They've come down in price, they've come down in size significantly. Each new unit that comes out, it seems like they're getting smaller and smaller. The prices on them are very reasonable for life-saving and life safety. It's a very reasonable amount of money to spend on something that, again, it's got a five-year battery in it. It's something that can really bail you out if you have an issue, if you're on the water, inland, and you have a major problem and you need somebody to come help you out.
So this is something that people really need to certainly take a second look at. I'm glad you're not far from Putnam County. You're probably about 45 minutes.
Yeah, we're about 45 minutes to an hour drive from here.
Right. So for more information, again, what was your website to get more information about this?
You can go to landfallnavigation.com. You can give us a call. You go to our website. Just type in Landfall on a search, and we pop right up. We're a local company. Been there for 30 years, and be happy to talk to you on the phone, or if you want to come into the store, we have a retail store, and explain them all to you person to person.
Terrific. I want to thank you very much
My
for
pleasure.
Being at the show, and it's always a pleasure. Thank you, and have a great evening.